And the athletes have just been told to get ready for this race. And by the way, the news of Peter Elliott and Chris McGeorge, third and fourth behind Sylvester and Co at the 800 metres. Personal best, Elliott 144.98 and Chris McGeorge 145.14. Really astonishing running. So what will the British do in this? Steve Ovett really getting a test rather prematurely, but he was unlucky enough in that 1,000 metres race in Edinburgh to be knocked over. And he hasn't really had the racing he needs to face a field of this quality. He'll line up on the inside. Although, just having a look at the draw has been revised, and Steve Ovett, in fact, lines up next to the outside. The athletes in this, Graham Williamson wearing number 8, 352, just over last weekend in Edinburgh, and he could be a real threat. Mark Fricker wearing number 39 will be the pacemaker. He comes from the States. John Walker, the former Olympic champion and world mile record holder, he wears 95. Then the two Spaniards, Jose Abascal, 353, and Jose Luis Gonzalez, the man who beat Coe last weekend. He has got a best to mile time of 349.67, to give you some comparative idea with this 1500 metres race. Persson of Sweden, Ray Flynn of Ireland, Pannonen of Finland, Harnestad of Norway, and Stromo of Norway. Those are the athletes. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11. Rather a big field on this very, very tight track indeed. The 130, Ray Flynn. 8 is Graham Williamson. There's a familiar figure of John Walker. Okay. 115, Gonzalez, who beat Coe. He's done 349, remember this man. He had a bad season last season through injury, but he's no mug. It was no great surprise to see him running so well. And the red-headed American in the centre is expected to make the pace. The 1,500 metres, the metric mile. We're on the wrong line, starting line, so sent back. So away they go this time. And it is Fricker, as we expected, out in front, making the pace. Steve Ovett back in fifth, sixth place.
Yeah, I hear you. Can he not get the crew to move?
Fricker still leading. Graham Williamson, where we expect him to be, in second place. Steve Ovett's gone third, clear of the trouble. Walker, four. Gonzalez there tucked in on the curb, and coming up on the outside is Ray Flynn of Ireland. The two Spaniards, by the way, running absolutely together. So as they come past where they'll finish in three laps time, it's Fricker the American in front. Second place, Graham Williams. Third is Flynn. Fourth is Ovett. In fifth place, John Walker. Sixth is Gonzalez. Seventh of Abascal. They go through 400 metres, and the time, 55.88, when Steve broke the world record, which stands at 331.36. He was very slightly faster than that, 55.51, so the pace is quick. Not that time will worry too many of them tonight. The battle on to beat Ovett and outfox him and really test him after his injury. Fricker leading, Williamson in second place. Flynn following Williamson, knowing full well that Graham hasn't got a sprint finish and that Graham Williamson will probably kick with 600 metres to go, certainly as soon as the pacemaker dies. Fricker still leading, Williamson in second place, Flynn is third, Ovett four, Walker five, Gonzalez six, Abascal in seventh place, and Persson of Sweden eight. 140 with two laps to go. And they're coming round now to complete 800 metres. 1,500 metres, remember, 3¾ laps of the track. And it's very quick. Ovett, the world record was 1:53, and the time is 1:53.8. So it's really on course possibly for a world record, but somebody's got to take it on shortly. Some fine pacemaking by Mark Fricker of America, a 3:39 man. Fricker still leading. Williamson in second place, where he's been all the time. Ray Flynn is third. And Williamson will make the break shortly, and there he comes on the outside. Now, he's got supreme and superb strength, as we saw at Edinburgh on Saturday, when in that gusty wind, he made the pace and ran 3:52, just beaten by Marie. But the fast finishers usually can catch him, so he's got to break them early. This is going to be a real test of courage on the last lap. Williamson leads, Ray Flynn second, Ovett's gone third, Gonzalez is four, Abascal five, Walker six, and in seventh place, Perth. And still Williamson, bowing his head as he does, and then driving for five strides, the head nod forward again. Graham Williamson leading, Flynn in second place, Ovett is third, Gonzalez moving up in the all blue now outside Ovett. Ovett wants to get off that curve if he can, and in fifth place of Abascal, Walker is sixth, Pearson seven. 200 to go, and still Williamson hasn't got rid of them. Flynn's run a great race in second place, and Gonzalez now threatening in third. Fourth is Ovett on the curve and trapped momentarily. In fifth place, Abascal coming through. And Williamson kicks again off the bench. And Abascal's the faller there. And Ovett comes through the centre. What a first he made then. Suddenly, Steve Ovett came to life. Chased by Gonzalez, but they're not going to catch him. Ovett has done it. Gonzalez second, Williamson third, Walker four, Flynn five, Pearson six. A magnificent run by Steve Ovett. 3:33.79. And the message will go round the world. The world record holder is back in everything. Abascal just trotting in. He was the unfortunate faller on the last bend. But Ovett, who seemed on the curb to be caught there, suddenly found a gap. And he wasn't involved in the incident at all. Ovett may have just have caught Flynn and Flynn moved across, but he's gone and saw the gap, went for it, and he got the speed, which is quite significant, to take advantage of the gap as it developed. He may well have actually caught Flynn as he went through. Certainly he didn't make contact with the Abascal, but Flynn did. But Steve Ovett looking amazingly strong. Gonzalez second, Williamson third. That is a World Championship qualifying time. A fine, fine piece of running. Although, I think, by Ovett's normal standards, he wouldn't have been too happy to be on the curb at that stage. David Moorcroft's comments will be interesting, because normally Steve Ovett controls the race from the shoulder of the leader, but Steve, once he saw a gap develop, well, like the decisive athlete he is, he went for it, and he got the speed to take it. Actually, we can now join Steve Ovett, I think, talking to Brendan Foster.
Congratulations, Steve. You look as though you really enjoyed that tonight.
Yeah, it's nice to not fall over or get cramp or whatever, but when they gave me this number, I thought, well, my luck must have changed. It's number seven.
So that's your lucky number. But it must be sweet coming back to Oslo after a year when obviously things didn't go really well for you. But yeah. To come back here and win in a world-class field.
Yeah, I think people were starting to write me off a bit.
Because you fell down.
Yeah. Well, you can always get up again. But, I mean, I think I'm coming through now quite strong. Another 4 weeks. I mean, that's my first 1500 in a year. So another two or three of those, and I reckon I'll be flying. Just needs a bit of time, really, Brent.
And you're looking forward to the Helsinki now?
If I'm selected, yeah. You never know, though.
Well done, Steve.
Thanks a lot, Brendan.
And you can see Steve Ovett again on BBC television on Friday night when he competes over 1,500 metres once more in the England-Poland-Austria-Belgium International at Perry Barr Stadium in Birmingham. Most of these internationals will be there. It should be a great night, but it's been a